Bam! What's doing, guys? Back with the Fresh Vinyl video. Today we're doing something a little different. No review. I'm kind of, what are we doing? We're doing, as you see in the title, we're doing, I'm ranking my Gigantic Series figures from, you know, least to favorite, best, whichever we're going to call it. And I'm only doing the figures that I have, because I know there's the Gigantic Godzilla 2019 from King of the Monsters. I don't have that, so I'm not going to judge it, because A, I haven't seen it in person, and I'm just judging what I have, okay? So, I was, you know, early this morning, I was sipping on some coffee, and I figured, you know what? I haven't done a review in a while. I don't really have anything. I don't have anything new to review. So I was like, why don't we do like a top, you know, favorites list of, you know, the Gigantic series. So maybe I'll do my favorite 30 centimeters, favorite 25, favorite Bandai, favorite Marmot. I don't know. Something to keep the ball rolling here. So that's what we're going to do. Without further ado, let's get this bitch going. Bam. Okay, in the number 8 spot, because I just had a count. I'm like, how many Gigantics do I even have? Number 8, as in least favorite. Yeah, it's like, how do you even rank these figures that you least like? It's hard because they all are really, really awesome in their own ways. But, you know, in order to do this, it's got, you know, somebody's got to take, you know, the caboose. Somebody's got to take the ass. Somebody's got to be the tail. Bam. Okay. So, the 1962 Gigantic Godzilla here is in the number 8 spot. I'm looking at it, I was like, do I really not like it? It's not even about that. It's just about, you know, just where they rank for me as to what gets my freshness going, okay? So, look, this figure came out in the winter of 2016, so, or early spring 2016. I had the privilege of being able to see these getting sculpted by Kaibitsua, you know, with X Plus. Obviously it's by X Plus, but when I was in Japan in 2015, a group of friends of us, we got to go and see this still in clay form, and it is really nice. I mean, it still impresses me now that I'm looking at it up close and personal rather than having it up on the shelf, which maybe will ignite my interest in the figure as a whole, but I mean, it's still a nice figure. The Rick version had blue dorsal plates. I didn't really need blue dorsal plates on this one. I like the way it looks standard. And it's awesome. The 62 is not one of my favorite suits. I don't even know where it would rank. Maybe that's for another video down the road, you know, rank all my suits or something, favorite suits. But this guy's got the number 8 spot. Overall, it really is a cool figure. Something about, and I'll mention this on another figure that we do up here, about this, I wish he was standing more upright. You know, why is he slouched over? You know, because if he was standing more upright, this would bring his height probably up another 4 or 5 inches, give or take. You know, giving it that much, you know, it just makes it feel bigger. But overall, this is a big figure. Okay? So, 1962, number 8 spot. Bam! Bam! Okay. Number 7. Whoa! What's happening here? Number 7, 1964 Gigantic Series? Number 7? Leslie Chambers, he's probably like, yo, man, Rich is fucking losing his mind here. What's wrong with this dude? Yeah, I'm a 64 mark. 64 is my bitch. You know, I love everything 64. Almost everything, you know. But I'm not afraid to sit here and say, you know, hey, this is not really that good. And it's not that it's not really that good. It's just I had the ball or the bar raised for a Gigantic Series 64. Okay? And it fell short. Why? If you see my reviews, or we talked about this on other videos or something or another, you know, the mouth is supposed to be a closed mouth. This is supposed to be a closed mouth. This is not closed. It's open. It's not what we were teased, you know, or when the figure was initially announced. It was supposed to be closed. So this is the Rick version. Yeah, it's got the extra jaw that's supposed to be closed, and the other piece is supposed to be open, and it's got the blue dorsal plates, which is pretty damn cool anyways. But it left a lot to be desired because I wish he was standing more upright. Again, like I had already said about the 62, if he was standing more upright with a perfect closed mouth, you know, it would have just been a ballpark, probably home run number 1 spot here for me, but it's not. It's at number 7, okay? And it's hard for me to give him that score or rank because I love the 64. Obviously, the number 1 collection, you know, figure and favorite 64 in my collection is this guy right here. Okay, that's the Rick 30 centimeter. Boom. That's perfection as of right now. But this guy just left a lot to be desired. It, overall, it sculpted good. You know, some people think that, you know, that feel that the hands are small. And I kind of agree. I think the hands are on a little bit of a smaller side. But I'm, that's not something I'm overly picky about as far as my concerns with the figure go. It's just I wanted a closed mouth. I wish he was more upright. He's in practically the same pose as Gigantic 62. Is that a problem? No, not necessarily. You know, it's just something I noticed that I was like, yeah, I mean, they kind of feel almost like the same figure. They're hunched, you know, over back, you know, towards the right a little bit. Tail is kicking off to the right and everything, whatever. But left a lot to be desired. Sorry, 64. Sorry, Leslie. Sue me. Bam. All right, moving on. Bam. Okay, in number five. Wait, six? No, six. Look, I'm really just shooting from the hip here. I didn't really think about this all that much. I did think about it, but, you know, this is hard. Okay, I don't do these rankings at all that, if ever. But number six, in the sixth spot, and this is, we're kind of getting into hard territory on which ones fall where. You know, I know what my top three are, or do I? I don't even know. But anyway, number six is the GMK. This is the first Gigantic Series figure that came out. I remember I was not going to get into the Gigantic Series at all, but I picked up this one from Hobby Link, I think, on like as a last minute whim buy. You know, click, buy, boom. I was like, all right, I might as well get it. Got it, and I was like, damn, man. Like, this guy's a beast. You know, it is awesome. He almost looks resin. He's got a lot of deep grooves going on in him, sculpt-wise. Like, I really have no complaints about it. Is it one of those ones that just doesn't do it for me? I do have a lot of GMK figures in the collection. Or I feel like I do. I've got a couple, you know, 30 centimeters and whatnot. But this one is nice. You know, again, for the first 30 centimeter, or Gigantic, this is what we got. I think the dorsal plates are, like, probably the most awesome part about the figure. But then again, like, the face is really done nice. His skin and his scales are just really, like, poof, all over the place. His teeth are nicely sharp and all that fun stuff. But, you know, he's in the number six spot in the middle ground here. You know, he doesn't have the high ground like Obi-Wan. The base is cool. The Rick came with a heart. I don't have the heart because I went standard. But I think the base is still pretty cool because, you know, some of these Gigantics need a tail stance, A, to either keep the figure posed how it's supposed to be or just to support the tail because it's damn heavy, okay? So this guy is number six. It is a badass figure. He was reissued, a couple times by X Plus, I think in a kit form where you had to build him up. I think that's how my buddy Brendan got his. Then they had the blue dorsal plate version, which looks really nice. The dorsal plates are blue. That's a cool gimmick for these, rather than being a light up, because it would be almost impossible to make these figures light up. But we'll talk about that on another figure. But anyway, that's number six. Number six. Bam. Number five. Number five is the Gigantic Series Godzilla 1954. Hard one. You know, we're falling. Again, like I mentioned, the last figure. This is difficult. This is not that easy to really rank them, at least for me, because I don't... It's just because I like them all in their own ways, for the most part. Sorry, 62, 64. But the 54, done by Yuji Sakai, he's basically like a gigantic version of the Yuji Sakai 30-centimeter figure, which I had since sold. Went on to another fresh collector. I kept the gigantic. It's awesome. It looks really great. It's obviously the first Godzilla, as we know. I got the Rick version. He came with, you know, the little mini bust with train biter head and his, you know, Godzilla logo sculpted, you know, into like rubble. Okay. So number five, I've even thought about selling this one. I was talking with Cody, you know, possibly was going to sell it, but it's hard to pull the trigger on selling some stuff, you know, because it's like, oh, am I going to miss it? And if I do miss it, then I'm like, damn, I shouldn't have sold it. So I'm at the point where if anything I'm selling, I better, you know, I don't want to miss it. So that's why I'm not going to sell nothing. And I'm actually just looking at this for the first time up here. His tongue, it's sculpted. Nice. Nice tongue, teeth, everything's all up there. Beautiful. So this is a great looking figure. The sculpt is really nice. You know, so really, I don't have any major complaints. It's nice that this one doesn't need a tail stand, you know, because the 54 tail... You know, for the most part throughout the movie, he was just dragging on the ground as he was walking through Tokyo and everything. But this is number five, so we're like right smack dab in the middle, and we're getting to the tough stuff next. Well, after, maybe, we're getting close to the tough stuff, okay? So number five, 54, boom. Bam. Okay. Number four. We're in the fourth spot now. Gigantic series, Godzilla 2000, Rick version. I went with the Rick because I felt like, you know, I already have a 30-centimeter and now a 25-centimeter Godzilla 2000 with purple dorsal plates, which looks really cool, all in all. But I was like, I need some difference, you know, with the figures because I don't want everything to be too similar and then it becomes stale. So I went with the Rick version. The orange looks really, really dope on this guy. You know, even if he looked like this throughout the movie, I think it would have been badass. It's just different, you know, and that's why I like going for, like, certain Ricks, because they stand out amongst the rest of their brethren, okay? This figure, smallest of the Gigantic series figures, also done by Yuji Sakai, sculpted beautiful, lots of sharp detail, like, these dorsal plates are sharp, even, like, the ones down the tail are even sharper, so if you want to, you know, scratch your back or something, you know, you definitely, it'll get the scratch, get that itch, and we'll scratch the shit out of you, okay? But the figure, it is really dope. I mean, it's the smallest one, but he's just so fierce looking. And this is based off of the Yuji Sakai, the maquette that was designed, you know, like the concept for Godzilla 2000. Not what we actually got in the film, but this would have been dope. This would have been really, really dope if this was what Godzilla looked like in the movie. I mean, not that I don't like the 2000 suit. It's nice. It's got, you know, it's callbacks to the 1962 suit. But this is just beastly. This is just ferocious. He's just beautifully scary looking. Lots of detail on this figure. So this is number four, okay? So we're going to... Number four. So moving into the top three, I don't even know where... Who I'm ranking in 3-2-1 at the moment, at this moment, okay? I think I do. But this top three is really, really hard. So let's find out who's in the top three. Bam. Okay, this is getting hard. Like, you have no idea really how hard it is to pick a top three here with the Gigantic series. It's a very, 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 very close race as far as I am, because it's like a debate. Like, I don't even know if I got this right, but I'm going with my gut here, you know. And what I'm thinking about, especially for these top three, is like which ones really capture that embodiment of what G said he was going for with the Gigantic series way back on Kaiju Cast video, Kyle Yount, when he sat down with X Plus back in, like, I think it was 2013 or maybe early. Yeah, it had to have been 2013. And, G said that he wanted the figures to feel powerful. And these top three figures capture exactly that, powerful. And that's what makes it really hard for me personally to pick top three. So top three, number third, is the second Gigantic series figure, the Gigantic series 1995 Burning Godzilla. I don't have his tail on right now because it's behind the shelves. I took him off for display purposes. And for those of you that watched, I think it was my Yuji Sakai Burning Godzilla review, I dropped the goddamn figure on the floor, scratched up his toenails and fingernails a little bit. And don't be a dumbass like me and pick your figures. Don't pick your figures up from the tail, especially this figure. It's not going to work. Now, overall, this figure, it's gorgeous. It is. I will never forget when I got the figure out of the box. I was blown away. You know, the ferocity, if I'm pronouncing it right. I'm not an English major. You know, he just so pissed off looking. The detail, it's gorgeous, especially the burning patches. You know, there's like two different like layers of clear vinyl. Or, painted reddish, orange, yellows in there to give it a nice sense of depth. It's from the burning patches to the dorsal plates. It looks beautiful. Like, even in the dorsal plates, it's like there's an inner and outer dorsal plate based off the translucency on some of those dorsal plates. It looks really, really good. He's just so pissed. I like how his eyes are just, like, you know, wide open. And, it looks really, really good. And I love this figure. So he's in the number third spot. Okay, so we're gonna move on to number two, and then obviously that's gonna tell you what number one is. And I really don't know. I don't know which way to go. Ooh, this is hard. So let's go. Damn, I'm telling you, this is tough. I'm not exaggerating. This is hard. Number two, Gigantic Series Godzilla 1989 Rick version with the glow-in-the-dark dorsal plates and the closed mouth. Badass figure. Really, 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 really badass figure. I love that it doesn't have a tail stand, or does it? And I don't know where the stand is. Doesn't matter. No, he doesn't have a tail stand. Doesn't need it. This figure, it's just gorgeous. Like, the sculpt is beautiful. It's perfect. The closed mouth is exactly what it should be. Okay? There's no open gap. I think some other collectors, maybe, I think mine appears to be closed more than others. But I don't know. It looks great. The glowy dorsal plates, I think, are dope. It's a nice feature. It's better than light up because you don't have to worry about plugging things in and batteries and worrying about electrical wires getting damaged or whatever. The paint job is I was going to say glorious. And it is glorious. Beautiful. The pose. It's amazing. He's standing upright. This is like almost everything that I wish I could have got with the 64. Sorry, 64. Sorry, Leslie. Sue me. You know, kidding. But this figure, it's just, it is gorgeous. I hope I got this right. Yeah, I think I did. If you haven't figured out already what number one is. But it's close. Like, it's the tightest race I've ever done. The eyes are just mean looking. He looks so pissed off. The teeth are beautifully sculpted. And I also like how you basically just swap out the jaws and everything. I got the other open mouth jaw somewhere in a box over here. But this is gorgeous. And the 89 is not really one of my favorite suits, but I've taken a liking to him a little bit more over the years, much like I've become a bigger Hedorah fan, you know, over the years, which is interesting. But this is a gorgeous 1989 Godzilla. Definitely not the last one I'm getting and not the biggest. Okay. So number two, and without further ado, we're going to move on to the number one. Boom. Bam. Number one. Gigantic series, ranked number one in my collection, is the Gigantic series Shin Godzilla from 2016's movie, Shin Godzilla. Okay, like, as I've been saying, the last top three figures, you know, these top three, it's been really, really hard. Like, it's probably, it's so close. It's very, especially the one and two, very, very hard. This figure, he's just disgusting looking. He captures that powerful, no different than this 89 does, or the 95. But this one, he's big. He takes up a lot of real estate. The detail is just, it's on point. It's disgustingly beautiful. The tail is just, it's a figure of its own. It's beautiful, especially the tip of the tail. But, you know, from the dorsal plates to his body, the way it's sculpted, just so like Freddy Krueger, stretched, burnt skin shit going on. It is just beautiful. The toenails, I mean, good thing he doesn't go for a mani and pedi, because he's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 toenails that I could see. There's going to be a lot of, you know, dipping your feet in the water and getting the cheese grater off and getting all that cheesy stuff off. You know, there's a lot going on here. I'm wondering what, like, the bottom of his toes look like. It's probably some calloused up and all kinds of other nasty radioactive shit going on down there, but that's okay. But yeah, this figure, it's beautiful. The face, it really just captures a nightmare. And what Shin Godzilla, or Godzilla, was in that movie, because he was a living nightmare of Japan's worst fears. We're talking, like, you know, he's creating earthquake, creating destruction, creating tsunamis. You know, it's like modern day Japan's disaster is combined all into one here. And that's what we got, in the movie itself. And I love the movie, you know. But this figure, it's just so, it's gorgeous. This is like a centerpiece. Like, people walk in, well, if they did walk in, you know, like, your eyes get pulled to this figure. I know my eyes do, you know, because he's just so disturbing looking. And he, you know, I think his eyeballs, he kind of captures like that 54 look, even though the 54 had bigger pupils, you know, all in all. But this one is just kind of like looking straight down, just evil looking. So, beautiful figure. This came out, what, 2016, 17, give or take? I forget. It's been reissued how many times now? The Rick version, he's purplish with an open roaring mouth. Yeah, there's been a couple versions of this, and it really is dope. So, number one, the 89, like, I'm telling you, like, that, this was right on his ass. Right on his tail. You know, really, really hard. So that's my top, you know, rankings for the Gigantic series. I'm not picking up the Mechagodzilla. There's going to be a guy again down the road. I'm not going to get that. Like I said, I skipped the King of the Monsters, Godzilla 2019. You know, it's just that movie. Like, I love the movie. Like, guilty pleasure. Like, it's a fun movie to watch. You know, we can talk about that at another point in time. But a fun movie to watch. A lot of fun. But I skipped that figure. It's just, I've mentioned this in the last few videos. I'm at a point where I'm trying to focus my collection. And you know, what I have behind me now and a couple shelves over there, it's like stuff that I really, really enjoy. So it's kind of given them a little bit more appreciation for me with my collection to enjoy what I do have rather than having a clusterfuck of shit behind me, blocking figures, blocking each other or whatnot, you know. So getting the stuff that really, really hits home, really hits the freshness. So that's that. I'll stop rambling there. I did have two cups of coffee, and so if it doesn't show. But I will see you on my next video. I don't know. Maybe I'll do a 30. Like I said in the beginning, I'll do this more with some other lines. Not just X Plus either. I got Marmots, Popey. Well, there's not many Popey figures. Vintage, Hedoras, CCPs, and all kinds of fun stuff. Don't touch the hair. Worked hard on that for like 30 seconds. All right, but that's it. Thanks for watching, guys. Hit me up in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video. Remember, people, buy vinyl, fresh vinyl. Bam!